This week on the Internet Cafe, creating your personal homepage. Will Maggot is only 11 years old, but he's a webmaster and a darn good one. We'll surf his site. If you log on to homestead.com, it's easy and free to create your own webpage. We'll show you how to do it. Michelle Johnson did it, created a great personal website. She'll tell us why it feels so good. But watch out if you have a bad website. You could get listed on this site featuring web pages that suck. Karen Willison has seen Phantom of the Opera 22 times. Guess what her personal website is about? Creating your personal homepage this week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One's Mathematics Tutor in a Box for school year 98-99, including 6 CDs and workbook.
So we're talking about personal web pages, and is it DeVries.com up there?
I did have my own web page.
I did,
and I'll tell you why I sort of let it decay and then finally gave up.
Yeah?
It's expensive to host your web page every week.
Come on.
It was expensive, and I ran out of things to say about myself.
Well, you are boring. That's
right. No, I'm not boring. You know, you got to keep inventing.
You got to keep it going.
And I couldn't get anybody to come to it. Okay, so I said, you know what, I better wait.
It's not worth it.
Yeah, but I am looking for something cheaper. If there's a better way to do it,
all right,
I want to find it.
Jane?
I'm just thinking about that digital camera in the bedroom, but that's just a discussion we probably don't want to go. Me? No.
No website?
I don't think so.
You against it?
You
don't want to tell your whole story to everybody?
I'm not that interesting. I mean, if I had this passion.
You need a publicist.
Yeah, well, maybe you and I should talk.
Sure.
But not even as a hobby. I mean,
I just don't have that. I just don't have anything interesting enough to talk about.
I tell you, you go to a party these days, and everybody says, "Well, do you have your own web page?" You know, and the answer actually right now for all three of us is no, except I have a business site, but not a personal one. Well, maybe we'll change everybody's mind by the time we're done.
We're talking about building home pages online, and I have to say that I still think most of the stuff used to build web pages is too complicated for kind of the average person. I don't see my mom getting even a WYSIWYG HTML editor and actually doing something. Homestead.com sounds like it may be a solution to that. What do you guys offer?
Homestead is actually a free service, which what we like to think is provides the easiest way for people or groups to kind of create their own web communities or websites without having to learn anything about how to program HTML, you know, install any software or transfer any files.
All right, so at homestead.com, I can create my own web page. Do I need any software or anything like that?
It actually all works within the web browser itself. And, you know, basically all you have to do is log into the Homestead editor, mm-hmm. and it actually brings up a Java application.
And I don't know, this is coming down, it's sort of invisible,
it's all sort of behind the scenes. And you just log in, and you don't need to know anything about the underlying technology.
Okay.
It brings up a Java editor,
right,
that allows you to go and drag and drop elements right onto what we call the stage.
Okay.
They're little canned elements from, you know, basic shapes, mm-hmm. all the way to a text editor, mm-hmm. to, you know, clip art, animations,
backgrounds, all that.
All the way to a full-blown, you know, chat room, mm. and scrolling.
Oh, really? So even like more advanced features, mm-hmm. like that. And I can put those on the page?
You can put them wherever you want. It's truly WYSIWYG. We allow, mm-hmm. you know, overlapping, layering, and dropping and resizing things anywhere on the page.
What about if I have family vacation photos or something else? Can I somehow get those in, uh-huh. there as well?
We offer the ability to actually import your own image. All you need to do is drag and drop our image importer, double click on that, and, you know, if you've taken digital photos and things like that, you can basically drag and drop that right off from your computer right onto your web page.
Okay, and then how do I actually get them up onto the web?
That's the beauty of offering it actually as a service as opposed to, you know, an HTML editor, mm-hmm. is that all you have to do is click on the publish button, and what it does is it generates all the HTML for you. You don't need to know anything about it. It sends it over to our server where we host it, and, you know, basically with a click of a button, all the HTML is generated and put directly on the web.
And it's up.
And it's up.
Wow, it sounds pretty easy. Now, you, mm-hmm. say this is a free service to create your page. What about to actually use that web storage and on the server? Is that
That's
a charge?
Also all free.
Okay, well, how are you guys making money? This sounds like too good to be true.
Actually, what we're planning on doing is, by the end of the year, also offering premium levels of service, you know, which will charge a subscription rate. Things for like small businesses mm-hmm. where we'll offer like e-commerce type elements, mm-hmm. things like maybe a family premium service. Well, there'll be cooler elements, really cool animations, little games, things
okay,
like that.
Okay, so that'll be kind of the mm-hmm. incentive there. Now, tell me, what are some examples of people who are using this site and how are they using it?
We actually get a lot of people that, you know, some people say, you know, I never really wanted to get through all the hassles. I didn't think I had the ability to get through all the hassles of creating my own web page. And we also have a lot of people that, you know, felt like they never really had a good reason to create mm-hmm. a web page. But now, because of the way Homestead's designed for groups mm-hmm. and people to build web pages together, you can actually create a page and then invite people to join your Homestead and collaborate and actually contribute that page together because it's all online.
Now, that's pretty interesting. I don't think that's actually something you can really do too easily with other types of editors and things like that.
And so what we kind of see is that it's actually empowering these people. Instead of creating standard kind of static HTML pages, what they're doing is they're creating a lot of group Homesteads, things for like little kids, little league teams mm-hmm. with their schedules and, you know, some of the scores from their last games, all the way to affinity groups like, you know, PTA clubs and all fraternities that mm-hmm. have pictures of their big bash last week.
Right.
And so.
Right. Well, great. Well, we'll have to check out the Homesteaders at homestead.com.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
So this is Michelle, and I've been looking at your website today, and it is very inventive, very clever. We're talking about personal home pages, and I wanted to ask you, I mean, it looks like a lot of time and effort and work went into your personal website. What motivated you to get into this in the first place?
I started about 1995, and it was just an experiment. There were very few home pages out then, and I just wanted to try my hand at the HTML and the graphics.
Uh-huh. And then what happened? I mean, you got into it. I mean, obviously, this became a big part of your life.
Well, I found that it was a great piece of turf for an individual to have, where you could combine your own graphics and your text to have your own freedom of expression.
Well, it seems more than that. I get the sense that this is an important part of your life. I mean, the way you get to express yourself on your website mm-hmm. is important to you. It's not just graphics and text, but this has now become a part of your life. Is that true?
Yes, it is. I've met a lot of people through there, and it's as an artist, which I consider myself, mm-hmm. it's very important to be, it's just another medium. It's an excellent medium uh-huh. to be able to use. And that people all over the world get to see it and communicate back. It's great for feedback.
And let me ask you, you have a section on there called, I think, The Art of the Personal Homepage.
Right.
And what is your personal view? You've done a very good job with that. Mm-hmm. What is the art of a personal homepage? What people are thinking right now as they're watching this, well, yeah, I'm going to put up my webpage. Uh-huh. What's a good one? What's a bad one? What's the difference?
Oh, for me, I like ones I think that have more meaning if you relate your personal experience mm-hmm. of life, what you've gotten out of it, what you learned, what you haven't learned, if you just share that with other people.
Well, you've certainly done that. I mean, you have your diaries, your personal diaries up mm-hmm. there. You've got, I think, a soul-searching section. I mean, we really get to know you better than a lot of people in the real world probably get to know you.
Yes.
Is that what it's about, you think? Or?
Well, yes, I feel like I have more anonymity, mm-hmm. you know, than just expressing myself to one-on-one with somebody. The web, it provides a screen between you and other people, and so they only get to relate to you according to your words, and a lot of the prejudices and that type mm-hmm. of thing are left out.
Now, you're doing, in fact, more than that, it seems to me. There's really a kind of woman's community. I mean, I had the feeling as a guy going onto your site that I was like overhearing a conversation of high school girls in the girls' room, you know, talking about stuff you don't ordinarily get to hear.
Right.
Is that part of the fun of what you're doing, too?
Yeah, there's when I first started on the web, it was, I think, 85% male, and I was searching for females, what else they were doing. I was real curious, and I think there's so much that was male-oriented. Mm-hmm. I wanted something that told the female experience.
All right, now you've done something very clever, Michelle's of the web.
Yes.
You've got, is this literally all the people named Michelle that are up on the web?
Not everybody. I keep promoting. We're out to dominate the web. I got a campaign
the
for
Michelles.
That. Yes.
And you have fem.mass. What is that?
That's fem mass. It's the personal homepages of the female masses.
Uh-huh.
I always hear people referred to as the masses, and I don't like that term at all. So I just wanted the females of the masses.
Okay.
And these are women who do express part of their lives on the homepage.
Now, in terms of, once again, expressing part of your life, what does this do for you? I mean, how important has this become to you? Would you miss it if you didn't have this website life?
Oh yeah, I've thought about shutting it down sometimes. But it's something about the sharing of yourself. Very important. And the sharing that you get back. Mm-hmm. I mean, you it's like soul touching and then going. It's not like you always establish firm relationships or anything, but it's just touching, sharing.
Well, you've done a great job, Michelle.
Oh, thank you.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cmptv.com.
So, Will, I'm pretty intimidated here. You've got a pretty cool website.
Yeah.
Now, what's it called?
GameFun.com.
And it's all about gaming?
Yeah, pretty much.
And you created the site all by yourself?
Yeah, and to help my friends.
Okay, so how many friends did you have working on this, too?
Probably about 3 or so.
Okay, so there's 3 of you, and you've pretty much done a lot of the coding for the site. Didn't you just change the site a couple of
years ago? Yeah, I remodeled it, and I changed, like, the overall look to it. I made new backgrounds and new graphics and a new home front page, and, yeah, it looks a lot better.
And so, and you've got all these, you've got different sections for different types of games. So you've got, like, Nintendo 64, and you've got PlayStation. What else do you have?
Super Nintendo, PCs.
So what kind of games would be there?
Like action, adventure, strategy.
Okay.
Stuff like that.
And so now what else is at your site? I mean, do you just have games that you can download, or do you talk about the kind of games that you've
got? I have games that you can download, games that you can just play in your browser, like Java games.
Okay.
Reviews of games and previews.
So do you write the reviews of the games?
Yeah, pretty much. My friends help me a little bit, too.
And so, now, do you get a lot of emails from people who check out the site?
Yeah.
And so what kind of things do they say?
They say good things and a little bit of bad things.
Bad things? What kind of things do they not like?
Well, my site's a little bit on the slow side.
Oh.
And it takes while to load the whole page.
So download time is, are you going to do something to fix it?
Yeah, I'm thinking about making a high bandwidth page and a low bandwidth page.
Okay, so now help me with this. Now, are you going to change the kind of browser that you're using? Is that a problem depending on the kind of user you've got?
Yeah, because it looks a lot better on Microsoft Internet Explorer, or because I use Front Page.
Okay.
And I would like it to look a lot better on Netscape because a lot of people are using it.
So do you have to
nowadays.
Sort of do some tweaking with the...
Yeah, okay. I do.
So what else would I find at the site?
You'd find graphics and pictures and background and a lot of cool stuff.
So I noticed you've got some rotating images there at the PlayStation and stuff like that. That was pretty
animated
cool.
Animated pictures.
I like that. And so now do you have people posting emails to you, and like, do you have a message board or anything? Or?
Yeah, I'm trying to start one, but it's kind of hard to do.
So now what do the kids in your school think about your site?
The kids in my school really like it, and I like it too, and I'm helping them making web pages, and they're helping me as well.
So you're learning and they're learning and everybody's kind of sharing? Does your teacher kind of go, wow?
Yeah, I actually made a web page for my class, and he helped me make it, and I helped him make it.
So do you think that helps you in school, doing all that stuff?
I put a lot of my projects at a web page and stuff, and I get good grades on that.
That's excellent. So now, do you also, do you plan to go anywhere with this website? Or
I'm thinking about making it more a little company and making advertisements and getting some money
out of it. So you're going to pay your way through school doing this, basically?
Yeah, probably.
Well, that sounds pretty neat. So, Will, what's next? I mean, how many hours a week do you spend on this site?
I work about an hour a day on weekdays, and then probably about 3 or so hours on the weekends.
Does it cut into playing outside?
Yeah, it does.
Does it?
Quite a bit, but I still have time for it.
So you have to work on that work-life balance thing, I think, sounds like.
Well, the question everybody asks me about designing your personal homepage is, what is the best software to use? Well, I'm going to duck the question and throw it over to Larry Maggot, our resident internet expert and LA Times syndicated columnist. What do you think? There's Microsoft Front Page, there's Claris Homepage, Adobe PageMill, all the same, or does it really matter?
They're pretty similar. They all have what in common is, first of all, they're programs you have to buy. They're premium programs.
$100 or more.
Exactly. And you use them to really manage your entire website, not just edit pages, but to move pages over to your site, to really get the entire site coordinated. So they're kind of high-end programs for people who have a fairly large site, that want to really keep it very much in sync.
And pretty much the same, maybe just your personal preference for the interface or whatever.
Yeah, pretty much. It's a look and feel issue. I mean, I like one better than the other, but it's a personal issue.
All right. There are freebies out there, though, right? You don't have to buy any of that stuff. You can go on to Netscape or IE or AOL and do this stuff for nothing.
That's right. You get AOL Press you can download. Right. IE comes with a really good editor, as does Netscape. They may not have a spell checker.
Uh-huh.
You may have to separately upload your file, so you would use something like WFTP to upload it. But for a simple site that has just a few pages, you're going to do fine with one of those programs.
All right, final question I always get is I'm working on my homepage, and I don't know, should I go for graphics or should I go for speed? What's the best thing to do?
Keep your graphics small and simple. And if you can possibly figure out how to compress them in a really tight way, you're going to be able to do more with less by using JPEG or GIF and getting them tightly compressed. But remember, people are downloading with 28.8 modems or even 14.4.
And they want it to be fast.
And they want it to be fast, absolutely.
Larry, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cnptv.com.
So, Karen, you're a junior at Stanford.
Yes.
And you went online in your first year, and it was, what, a couple of days after you...
Right after I got there, I was looking for some information on Phantom of the Opera because I've been writing a novel based on the story, and I just found a news group to find more information, and that got me started.
And you went from there. And we're actually talking about personal web pages. You've got a, I'd say it's more than a personal web page. You've got a pretty significant site going called Shadowsong.com. And it's basically, what would you call it, a fan site? Or
it's a
more
little,
than that?
It's a little of everything. It's certainly a fan site. But it's also, I also offer web design services, and I also maintain the official page for San Francisco's Phantom of the Opera, Frank D'Ambrosio.
Wow. And I bet he was really appreciative of being able to be online, too.
Yes. It's a great way for his fans to meet and talk to the discussion board. And
so do you get a lot of emails back and forth from other fans about the site and that type of thing?
Oh, yes, I do. In fact, I actually run an email list for discussion of Phantom of the Opera. And yes, and of course, I get a lot of comments on the site and on my novel.
Now, on the Phantom, is it a global phenomenon, or is it mostly in the U.S., or do you find you've got people all over
the world? There are people, I mean, a large percentage are from the U.S., but there are also a lot of people in England where it started, and there are people in Australia, just everywhere you can possibly imagine.
What do you think it is about the Phantom that's so appealing?
I think it's the story. It's just, it's the most beautiful story about acceptance and about seeing beyond outward appearances to see the real person.
And so now, there's a lot of really interesting stuff about the Phantom at the site. You've also got the story. You're actually a writer. And
yes.
So you've written, you haven't completed the book yet, though, have you?
No. It's about halfway done or so, a little over halfway done.
So you got any sort of date to get it finished?
No, I don't.
It's an ongoing
busy
book.
A student, of course, as well as, of course, you know, designing sites for various people and things like that.
That's right. Now, so you started the site because of your love of the Phantom, and it started growing, as sites always have a tendency to do that, and now you're hosting the Phantom site, literally.
Mm-hmm.
And now you've started your own business, is that right?
Yes, I do. I offer web design services, anybody who's interested.
How do you find time between school and the site itself, and then...
I'm just a very busy person.
I
really enjoy all of it, so it's worth it.
Now, there was one area of the site which I got particularly attracted to was a picture of the Phantom, and it looked surprisingly like Antonio Banderas. What's that all about?
That's right. We are protesting the proposed casting of Antonio Banderas as the Phantom in the upcoming movie because basically a lot of fans feel that he's completely wrong for the role, that he lacks the experience in the role, and he lacks the operatic and musical theater training to be able to carry it.
And he's a bit of a hunk. I mean, he's not what you'd think of as the Phantom.
He's not. The Phantom is talented, and you love him because of himself as a person. You don't love him because he's handsome. In fact, he's not handsome. He's disfigured.
It seems kind of counterintuitive.
Exactly.
Now, when I think of the Phantom, I think of Michael Crawford, who I think is a phenomenal singer, and he's sort of the epitome of the Phantom. Are you pro Michael Crawford for the Phantom?
Yes. I mean, we would definitely support him. We feel there are a lot of problems with the whole idea of making a movie, but I mean, certainly, if they were willing to cast Michael Crawford, that would show that they have a commitment to making this a good movie and truly being faithful to the musical on stage.
So any plans for the site? Any new things that you're going to be doing?
I'd like to add a few things to my personal page about my concern for the environment and animals. And I'm sure I'll be adding to my Phantom site as there are new developments, of course.
Yeah, for sure. Well, it's a great site, shadowsong.com. Thanks a lot, Karen.
For URLs of today's featured websites, check out the Internet Cafe site at cnptv.com.
So we're talking about home pages tonight, and I've got the experts here, Vincent and Michael, from Web Pages That Suck. Give me an example of some web pages that just really suck.
A good example is any page that has 7 or 8 animated images on it. Yeah. Automatically, that qualifies as a page that sucks.
Because it's too slow?
Well, it's too slow. Most of the animated images you're probably going to see are either clip art or they've been stolen, and they add nothing to the site other than the fact that somebody's trying to say, I'm a pretty cool guy.
Okay.
Unfortunately, a lot of the personal pages do just that.
Really?
Typically, it's overkill.
It's just too much on the site.
Too much of everything.
Well, what is an example of criteria that people should follow for building their own personal page? Is there a few things they should sort of think about?
The first thing is restraint. Do they actually need to have whatever they want to put on there? Do they need a 256K image of Aunt Emma on their page? Mm-hmm. Do they need a Java application running that says what time of day it is? Do they need, ask the big question, do I need to have this?
The actual site.
Do I need to have this element on my page? Will this make it better? And if the answer is no, get rid of it.
Okay. So you guys created web pages that suck. And tell me a little bit about the origin of that site and how it got going.
Basically, it got started because I didn't want to teach a course on HTML. I was teaching a course on HTML. I didn't want to teach design.
Okay.
And my boss said, put up a site that talks about design. So I put up a site that said, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this, and don't do this. And if you don't do these things, you'll have a site that looks good. Things like don't put animated images, don't put too big of images on, don't put Java apps on, things like that.
So out of this site grew, also I understand, a book. And tell me sort of what the book does that the site maybe doesn't, or how do they complement each other?
Well, the book goes a little bit farther, a little bit more in depth, and provides a lot of different tips and techniques. Something the website didn't. The website was a little bit more of the stripped down version.
So the website really just gives you the hardcore examples, and this kind of shows you how to do it.
Yeah, it goes into a little bit more. It's a great deal for fixing and preventing a web page that sucks. Mm-hmm. That's kind of what we like to tell people.
And I understand you guys have become a little bit of web celebrities. You're out
We're
here speaking. You're
We're
here.
We're here.
Yeah.
This is proof. We are celebrities.
We've hit the big time.
What's next for Web Pages That Suck?
Web Pages That Suck, the movie.
With Liv Tyler.
Really?
Yeah.
Is someone you know specifically, or?
Dream.
Liv Tyler, yeah.
It's a dream, it's a fantasy. But hey, we went this far.
But seriously, are you guys going to plan to do any kind of trainings around this? Do you do that type of stuff now?
Yeah, speaking engagements and that kind of thing. We'll be at Internet World Chicago in July. So that'll be kind of exciting.
So you're becoming experts.
We're becoming experts.
Recognized experts.
Yeah. Right. And how did you guys get into this to start with?
I taught him how to design web pages. Write web pages.
He's
not
my mentor.
Okay. I have his mentor.
Aren't you the HTML guy and you're the graphic design guy? Is that kind of how
That's how it started.
The first
page he ever made was better than anything I'd ever created. So I said, I got to work with this guy.
Match made in heaven.
Match made in heaven.
Okay. Well, Web Pages That Suck, the movie, I think we'll go out and look for it. Hopefully,
for sure.
Next summer?
Yeah.
Sure.
Well, Jane, I want to know if anybody changed your mind today. Did you get inspired to start Wither.com?
No.
Wither.com?
But I have to tell you that Karen's website was really quite extensive.
Yeah.
But Will, my 11-year-old buddy.
He challenged you.
He's definitely challenged me in a big way, so I think
You're
I'm
going
to have to start doing some coding.
About you?
No, I think I'm going to do something else, but I won't tell you yet because
it
I don't know.
Won't be the Jane Ego sign.
Wow. No pictures of Jane.
Did you find a cheaper alternative?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Talking to the guys at Web Pages That Suck,
yeah.
I realized that my first web pages really did suck.
So you're glad you're out of business on
I'm
that one.
Throwing those out, I'm starting over again, and homestead.com is a great place. It is free,
easy,
and that's what
free.
I was looking for, cheap. And easy.
We got you down.
Yeah, so I'm ready to go.
Well, what I thought was really cool is talking to Michelle, for example, how this is an important, integral part of her life now. I mean, she tells her personal story. This has become the way she expresses herself and meets friends. And it's just not a website to her. I mean, a lot of people are really using this as part of the way they exist in this world. I think it's a fascinating change in what people do. Anyhow, that's our look at personal homepages here at Cybersmith. Hope to see you here next time at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience. A Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults.
To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify the show number and the topic.